Hello friends, this video we are going to discuss about Microsoft PL900, which is Microsoft Power Automate certification questions and as well as answers. So the first question is, you have a Power Apps app, so you are created the new version to publish a new version. Then customer asking to restore in the previous version of the app. Now in that case, what happened? You will see the two versions. Here you can select the options. So how it would work. So when we are talking about the versioning, you can see, if you see this, you can open your powerapps.com and then click tap apps in navigation bar. So near the right edge, you can see the option restore. Also you have the option in the tab or the versions tab right, you can see the restore option is available. You can see the two versions of the things as well. You can click or tap restore, a new version is added to your list. Here you can see usually the version which you want to publish, or else previously you have two versions, the restoring versions now come into the picture of publishing version. So now you can see, so how many versions in your app. The question is, how many versions you can see? You can see 3. Here the answer is 3, and here you can see, because already 2 versions are available, now you are going to restore, so you are getting the new version of publish. So answer is 3. Question number 2, you can see right, a company uses Dynamic 365 Sales. The company uses a browser-based app named Sales Hub. You need to ensure that users can access data from mobile devices. So which app should user install? So here you can, for PL900 questions, you can go with examtopics.com. There you can get the latest updated questions, the real-time questions you can get, and as well as discussions and solution as well, they will put in all that. See, when you see about Dynamic 365 mobile devices, then probably you might go to Dynamic 365 for phones option. So this is the correct answer. So how it would be correct? Here you can see they are revealing the answer. Use the Dynamic 365 for phone and Dynamic 365 for tablets. If you here the question is the browser based app. The company has browser based app. The user can access data from mobile devices. So we have to ensure whether user have access data for the mobile devices. So if user want access for mobile devices, then definitely Dynamic 365 for phone should be installed in the app. Maybe the phone or tablet, they should install Dynamic 365. So what is that? If you see that, it will automatically access all the apps you need your role. You will see the apps, the new unified interface on your mobile devices. So Dynamic 365 for phones is important for seeing mobile devices access for Power Automate. Here the question 3 is, you are a customer service manager. You need to implement a Power Apps portal that allows customers to submit cases. So which type of data source it is used? So usually here you can see there is 4 options. Azure Data Service SharePoint 365 connector. So when you see that, Share mostly Power Automate using the SharePoint, because so what is the purpose of SharePoint is, suppose maybe multiple bots, maybe high density robots, maybe the two or three bots it's running in a process. So the SharePoint easily share the data with multiple architectures, maybe the multiple robots. So that is the reason usually the Power Automate or Power Apps portal used as a SharePoint. So here they are given, SharePoint can be set up of customer feedback. That also one more part. The customer feedback you can set it. The Power Up uses finance and operation connector to grab sales order information, and SharePoint connector to connect, write the data to the SharePoint list. So what would be the question for? The question for we will see at a later point of view. And now I am moving next question. So when you are moving new questions, they will defaultly they will ask for you are not a robot. Here you can see a distribution company has multiple warehouses. Tax rates charged on sales order need to be calculated based on locality and region. You need to recommend a cost effective solution that can be implemented quickly. So what should you recommend? Here they are giving the five options: offshores, alert, in dynamic implement the common data model, run a Power BI report, write scripts and code, update. Here you can see the correct answer is create alert in Dynamic 365 Finance for tax table changes. So why we need Dynamic 365? See, we already saw that previous question. So the Dynamic 365 will be automatically take charges, which means it will automatically encapsulate your, so your requirement based on the requirement, it will be the maybe the locality or region or maybe the phone or tablet. So it will be easy to adapt the things in, through Dynamic 365. So that here the cost effective solution is Dynamic 365. Usually Microsoft Power Automate, think through that the Power Automate has specially designed for to use their Microsoft open applications like and Microsoft licensed versions like Dynamic 365 and Power BI and Power Apps and Power Automate. So these kind of things are referring, and they will should use Power BI, Dynamic 365, SharePoint. So you mostly they are planning to cover Microsoft products. So instead of creating the, here you can see data model, not so you can, if you create data model, that would be the another step you have to produce your effort, because Power Automate, the main purpose of Power Automate is no code, low code. So this purpose you can use Dynamic 360 only. So another answer they have provided, check application source. So even if you check the application source as well, it could not work. Run a Power BI report. So if you run the Power BI report, Power BI is nothing but that business intelligence. This is kind of analytics report. Here we, for cost effective, we, if you want to do cost effective, you don't need to go for reporting mechanism. And fifth one is write a script and code tags out. So writing script, instead of using Dynamic 365, writing script is somewhat efficiently you are working with another code. So the correct answer is create alert in Dynamic 365. So now I'm going to next question. So you need to implement Microsoft Business application along with the Microsoft Power Platform. So which three Microsoft products are part of the Power Platform? Each correct answer percent a complete solution. Here you can see. So what we are learned previously, Microsoft usually they are pushing to take their own product like Power Automate. This Power Automate can use Power Apps. This Power Apps will take the reporting for the Power BI. Here you can see answer is A, C, E. If you see that, A, C, E. Because Power Apps is their product, Power BI is Microsoft product, and Power Automate is their product. If you see the PL900, this is only for the Power Automate. So this kind of hotspot we can go later because so initial session as well, if you go with hotspot you will get some more struggle. The large retail company implements Power Apps, Microsoft Flow and the common data service. So they are implementing three, Microsoft Flow. So previously Microsoft Flow is called as now Power Automate. The board of directors is asking whether the users are finding value in the technology. The company would like to measure and report usage of the software. You need to recommend a tool to determine software usage. Here you can see the four options is there: Microsoft Intune, Azure and Power Platform and Dynamic 360 Product Insight. Here you can see the correct answer is C, Power Platform Analytics. This all analytics usually help us the report generation and report usage, and you can create default reports based on your environment. Maybe if it is finance, you can create financial related, environment related report so across the finance data users. So also admins can filter the view with attributes like device, platform, player version, or country, state and city like that. So Power Platform Analytics is the correct for this answer, because here the ask is board of directors asking whether users are finding value in the technology. The company would like to measure and report usage. The main thing is usage of the software, so that we are using Power Platform Analytics tool. Here Azure Stream, Microsoft Intune, Dynamic 365, these all are nothing but they are not related to analytics. Only the Power Platform is Platform Analytics is the tool which is related to the Power Automation. Thank you guys, thanks for watching this, and in our next session we will take out some other questions. Thank you so much.